Good morning, everyone. Today is what, Tuesday? Taco Tuesday? Let's see. I forgot that we had to finally reschedule the shipping container for Recoil to today. And I had a meeting at 10 scheduled with the inspector because the city didn't like that we have an RV parked in our front yard. They said it needs to be covered by a 6-foot opaque fence. I'm like, okay. Like, basically, I think they want a screen, you know, but like, fence is a strong word. But, scheduling conflicts, I pushed that out till Thursday. Yeah, Thursday. Thursday at 10. So, and then Laura, I guess, heard her back yesterday or last night or something, and so she cannot make it this morning. So if anybody sees this and is in the Phoenix area and you want to make some quick cash today, please come and help me, or contact me, 602-312-6504, if you want to help us unload the shipping container at Recoil. So putting that out to you guys. I'm going to have a talk today about a certain local brand over in Tempe that one of their founders has COVID and is in bad shape and has been sitting home watching all my videos bashing their brand. So I always, you know, it's always funny. I always thought that was a weird thing to say when going into like a forum, when they would say no brand bashing. And I was like, well, why not? You know, like, if you have an opinion, what's the big deal? So, but, you know, when you think about it, if everybody is a greedy thief, you know, you and anybody starts, you know, shaking the boat, that, you know, hey, there's money for everybody. And it's like, well, there's not really money for everybody. That's the whole point, is that the big dogs are taking all the food. And then they tell the little dogs, fuck off. So, of course, it's not a verbal fuck off. It's a physical fuck off. It's a, you know, good luck. You know, you don't have the marketing power and the buying power that, you know, they do. So there's really no hope for someone that's small. So I disagree. I think there's lots of hope. It just requires someone like, I don't know, me, to be resourceful and different and to be creative in a way that they're not willing. There's something, you know, even something that's beneath them. That's what's funny is anytime anybody bashes me, I find that funny. And like spinach to Popeye. You know, it's like, that makes me strong. Well, because I know they're full of shit. So I know how these big companies work and I know the prices that they get. And they would be offensive if people found out what they really were. And so I find that it's a weird thing. Like, you know, especially with a really big brand, you know, big company that does over $100 million. Like, why do you care what little old me says on my YouTuber channel? If I say, you know, whatever, fuck Apple. There you go. If I say fuck Apple, it's like, Tim Cook's really gonna come after me? Like, what the fuck? You got nothing better to do, Tim? So, but, you know, of course you notice that I'm not mentioning any particular brand, and that's fine. You guys can figure it out. You know, sometimes people find another way to be, to show their protest, you know, like people that don't like, well, it's more like, I don't think that Trumpers hate Joe Biden. I think they just hate that Trump's not there. So that's what's funny. So, but in order to express their hate, they say, fuck Biden. And then what the media has done is basically made that phrase illegal. And it's easy to track and it's easy to censor and all that shit. So what do Trumpers do? They say, go Brandon. See? There you go. Go Brandon. And it's, you know, it's not like some secret code, you know, that nobody knows about. It's kind of, I think it's funny, you know, it's like, but if, you know, you say fuck Trump in his orange butthole, then, you know, people get offended about that too. So it's there's snowflakes all around, I think is what I'm saying. I think all of us can benefit from, I don't know, maybe having a tougher skin, maybe allowing other people to have opinions. You know, there's a lot of things that a lot of big companies do that I don't like. You know, I don't like what Apple does, but, you know, when Warren Buffett says that, you know, Apple is like one of the best, most powerful companies, I kind of laugh because of how Apple panders to old and dumb people and people with just more money than, you know, smarts. And you know, it, you know, and of course Apple frames themselves as, you know, a savior to these people, even though Jitterbug's pretty fucking rad, if you ask me. Jitterbug! You know, the Apple is the one that, you know, your grandmother uses, and then if she has a problem with it, she doesn't mind going down to the Genius Bar and spending, you know, $1,000 to fix a $20 issue. So, because, I mean, she's not dead yet, and you haven't gotten your inheritance yet, so it's her money still. But, I don't know, I'm curious to find out about my meeting today and about the personal relationships with the people that I have been collaborating with, and it'll be interesting to find out how that meeting goes. So, but I don't have any more thoughts on it this morning. What I want to say is I love you guys. Thank you for your support. May Gonzo bless you with creamy ropes. Oh, that was funny. Somebody asked me what a creamy rope was the other day. I'm like, well, why don't you Google Peter North? Okay, he's the creator of creamy ropes. Okay. So, I didn't take pictures yesterday. Sherry was able to make a llama yesterday, like a stencil. And we put that on our first pair of Jizz Llama 6.5-inch components out yesterday. It was fucking great. So, but thank you guys for your support. May you all have a healthy llama to jizz on and share with your friends. We are going with the white llama, simply because it's a little more, how do you say? I don't want to say polite, but it's convenient. There we go. It's convenient that, you know, like let's say you bust a nut on your white llama. And then, you know, your friend wants to fuck your llama. The llama is white, so you don't really see the load. See? So it's a very nice thing. So that's going to be our mascot, is a white llama. And I would love to see, like, rappers support Jizz Llama and be like, you know, yeah, man, this is the lifestyle. You got to have a llama. And, you're not so... you know, tall, you can have an alpaca. So that's like the little friendly cousin, little cute furry cousin to a llama. Llama's kind of actually kind of big. So, but alpacas are like a little smaller, a little more fuzzy. But I would love to start seeing llamas everywhere. And if you look, you will see llamas everywhere. And because I've contaminated your brain like a virus, you'll see it in all sorts of things. I'm sure now that, you know, I've talked about creamy loads, and of course these are all things that people think about, you know, but they don't really talk about. And I think it's important to talk about. I think it's important to have a good, strong, you know, soft llama. No, not like a camel. A camel will spit and bite. You don't want to fuck a camel. But a llama you can trust and rely on. So I'll put a link in the description of when I got first exposed to llamas. It was on Sesame Street. And it said that me and my llama are going to the dentist today. So that's an old, it's an oldie but a goodie. So anyways, I love you guys. I'm almost to the recoil to help them unload today. Again, if you're in the Phoenix area and you would like to help us There is a cash reward for your help at the end of the day, and even more reward if you decide to take about what's behind door number two, which is product. So I love you. Talk to you later. My phone number is 602-312-6504.